we've got one of the pioneering Christian recording artists that I was telling him tonight. And by the way, go on our website and look at some of the interviews we do. I do what we call On Stage at the Upper Room, where we do a videotaped interview with the two guests that are here tonight, and every month that we do that. And we put those on, and they're a great little expose on the person. But I was talking to Scott tonight, and I said, you know, back in the day, it's been 39 years ago now, that we had one of your songs in our wedding. And I said, I'll bet you too. I said, Scott, I bet if you had a dime for every time somebody told you that, you'd be a rich man right now. So, but what a guy, and he had big, big bushy hair back in the day and a big beard. And so now he's got shorter hair, and he's still singing like a great musician and a wonderful friend of the Upper Room. This is not his first time here. But would you please welcome to the Upper Room stage, Scott Wesley Brown.
Thank you so much. Change the effect there, that might help. Well, I am so excited to be here tonight, and one of the reasons is I got a free pen, so this is really a real big treat, Ron. I appreciate it. Well, I have gone from being full-time on the road to being now a full-time chaplain at a chapel out in the desert. And it's been a great transition of being able to minister to people on a continual basis. And looking out over the congregation each week, I can see people's lives who've been changed, been touched, been redeemed, healed, all of these great things that God has done. So how many people here have been redeemed? I suspect you have. Yes. How many people have been healed by the Lord? Have you? Yeah. Restored. Seen restored relationships. And well, I wrote a little song just to kind of celebrate that. And it's called House of the Lord. And we're going to put the lyrics up. And I want to invite you to sing it with me. It goes like this. Here in the house of the Lord, broken lives are restored. Once empty hearts sing in one accord. Sing that with me. Here in the house of the Lord, broken lives are restored. Once empty hearts sing in one accord. Here in the house of the Lord, there is love, there is grace, as His presence fills this place. Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, we adore. He is awesome, He is great, there's forgiveness in His name. We rejoice in the house of the Lord. We rejoice in the house of the Lord. Amen. You sing it with me again, here we go. Here in the house of the broken lives are restored. Once empty hearts sing in one accord. Here in the house of the Lord, there is love. There is love, there is grace, as His presence fills this place. Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, we adore. He is awesome, He is great, there's forgiveness in His name. We rejoice in the house of the Lord. We rejoice in the house of the Lord. Honor, power, and glory are yours. Honor, power, and glory are yours. Honor, power, and glory are yours. Honor, power, and glory. There is love, there is grace, as Your presence fills this place. Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, we adore. You are awesome, You are great, there's forgiveness in Your name. We rejoice in the house of the Lord. There is love, there is grace, as Your presence fills this place.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, we adore. You are awesome, you are great, there's forgiveness in your name. We rejoice in the house of the Lord. We rejoice in the house of the Lord. One more time. We rejoice in the house of the Lord. Amen. Is that true? Yeah.
I want to teach you an old little gospel song. Here goes like this.
Glory, 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 somebody touch me. Glory, 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 somebody touch me. Glory, 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 somebody touch me. And I know it was the hand of the Lord. Sing that with me. Here we go. Glory, 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 somebody touch me. Glory, 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 somebody. Yeah, glory, 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 somebody. And I know it was the hand of the Lord.
Now I want you to think back to when it was that the Lord first touched you. It might have been on a Monday or Wednesday or Sunday. What I want to do is sing through each day of the week, and I want you to stand up on the day that the Lord touched you, all right? You only have to stand up for one day, but just stand up and sing it out with all your heart, all right? So let's try Monday. Anybody get saved on a Monday? You stand up and sing.
Well, it was on a Monday, somebody.
Come on now.
It was on a Monday, somebody. Yeah, it was on a Monday, somebody. And I know it was the hand of the Lord.
How about Tuesday?
It was on a Tuesday, somebody touched me. It was on a Tuesday, somebody. Yeah, it was on a Tuesday, somebody. And I know it was the hand of the Lord.
How about Wednesday?
It was on a Wednesday.
Stand up. Come on now.
It was on a Wednesday, somebody. Yeah, it was on a Wednesday, somebody. And I know it was the hand of the Lord.
How about Thursday?
It was on a Thursday, somebody touched me. It was on a Thursday, somebody. Yeah, it was on a Thursday, somebody. And I know it was the hand of the Lord.
Friday!
It was on a Friday, somebody touched
me. Come on!
It was on a Friday, somebody. Yeah, it was on a Friday, somebody. And I know it was the hand of the Lord.
Saturday!
It was on a Saturday, somebody touched. It was on a Saturday, somebody. Yeah, it was on a Saturday, somebody. And I know it was the hand of the Lord.
Sunday!
It was on a Sunday.
Whoa! Come on!
It was on a Sunday, somebody. Yeah, it was on a Sunday, somebody. And I know it was the hand of the Lord.
Glory, glory,
glory, glory, glory. Somebody touch me. Glory, 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 somebody. Yeah, glory, 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 somebody. And I know it was the hand of the Lord.
Now there are some people who cannot remember when it was the Lord touched them, but you know he did, amen? So if you're like me, I can't remember when it was. I just know he did. I want you to stand up real tall and proud and say,
well, I don't know just when somebody touched me. I don't know just when somebody, yeah, I don't know just when somebody, but I know it was the hand of the Lord.
Everybody stand, come on.
Glory, glory, glory.
Sing it out now.
Glory, glory, glory. Yeah, glory, 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 somebody. And I know it was the hand of the Lord.
Amen. That was fun. It always just confuses me, though. There are some people who stand for like two or three days in a row. I don't know. But you know he touched you, and you're here tonight, and we're in the house of the Lord, because wherever two or three are gathered, there he is in our midst. Amen? And that is so unbelievably cool. And it's just a privilege to be here. Ron, thank you. just honored to be here. And Dana, you guys are going to love what he's bringing forth tonight. It's going to be great. And years ago, I was leading worship, and right in the middle of this worship set at the church I was ministering, I just felt this heaviness. And I remember after we were done, I turned around to the worship team and I said, boy, I feel like I just had a heart attack. And I had a heart attack. I mean, right in the middle of worship, but what a better time. I mean, just to go ahead and go right on the glory. And I just remember the doctor as I was being rolled into the emergency room, and I'd kiss my wife, and I just didn't know what was going on, and I just looked up at this doctor, and I said, am I going to be okay? And he said, son, you're going to be just fine. And that's so true. No matter which side I came out on, I was going to be just fine, because God is sovereign, and for me to live is Christ, and for me to die is gain. And that was when that verse really became real to me. An understanding that each one of us are in God's hands, and he is a mighty, powerful, loving, great, almighty God who just loves us intensely and will never allow any harm to come to us when he has us in his hands, which is all the time, no matter what we face in life. And so there was a song that I wrote a long time ago, back in the 1880s, and as a matter of fact, it's available on 8-tracks out there in the. But a little song called He Will Carry You goes like this. I use my band in a box back there. Go ahead, brother. He's coming. There we go.
There is no problem too big God cannot solve it. There is no mountain too tall he cannot move it. And there is no storm too dark God cannot calm. There is no sorrow too deep God cannot soothe it. If he carried the weight of the world upon his shoulder, I know my brother that he will carry. Cannot solve it. There is no mountain too tall he cannot move it. And there is no storm too dark God cannot calm it. There is no sorrow too deep not soothing. If he carried the weight of the world upon his shoulder, I know my brother that he will carry you. If he carried with me, would you? If he carried the weight of the world upon his shoulder, I know my brother, that he will carry you. If he carried the weight of the world upon his shoulder, I know my sister, that he will carry you. He will carry you. He will carry you.
Thank you. Well, Ron was talking about a song that I wrote that he had in his wedding. I wrote this song for my wedding. The only problem was that I wrote it a year after we got married, so I was kind of late for the... It goes like this. This is the day that the Lord hath made, and I'm so glad. With each rising sun, you are here by my side. You are more than a dream come true. Oh, to have you, to hold you, to love you, to pray, to share with, to care with, to hold hands and say, this is the day. The love that the Lord hath made, that you and I are one. Love's mystery is unfolding today, written for us in the sun. Oh, for better, for worse, for rich or for poor, each day that passes, I'll love you more, 'cause this is the day that the Lord hath made, and I will rejoice with you. This is the day. This is the day, yeah. This is the day, yeah. This is the day, yeah. You know, I never realized until I wrote that song that, you know, you can get married to 16 different people. Did you know that? Four better, four worse, four rich, and four poor. Well, years later, after having two precious little girls, we had two precious little granddaughters. How many are grandparents here? Amen. 30 million Christian grandparents in the United States. Did you know that? But I'll tell you something. We've got a lot of responsibility to raise them up as godly little grandkids, and so that they become godly adults. And they've got it tough out there in the world. And my good friend Bruce Carroll and I have gotten involved with an organization called the Legacy Coalition. and they do grandparenting seminars, and it's so cool to learn how to grandparent in a godly way, strategic grandparenting. Isn't that cool? Intentional grandparenting. And I heard a guy one time saying, we're supposed to leave our imprint in the lives of other people. And I thought, imprint? Well, maybe as grandparents, we can leave our grandprint in the life of our grandkids. So Bruce Carroll is a good friend of mine, and we sat down one day and we wrote this song and put a little video to it, and I hope it just touches your heart and it just encourages you to love these precious little ones that God has entrusted to us. Amen. Amen. Grandparents.
Pictures hang upon our wall from the time when you were small, and each night before we sleep, we pray the Lord your soul to keep. To our children's children, we've just one wish, that you'd know Jesus Christ for who he is. When all is said and done, we pray we've left his mark through our grandprints on your heart. Through our grandprints on your heart. From finger paintings on the fridge to soccer games and your first kiss, through it all we've tried to show that Jesus loves you, this we know. To our children's children, we've just one wish, that you'd know Jesus Christ for who he is. When all is said and done, we pray we've left his mark through our grandprints on your heart. Through our grandprints on your heart. And year by year we grow in grace to leave a legacy of faith, that together we will see him face to face. To our children's children, we just one wish, that you'd know Jesus Christ for who he is. When all is said and done, we pray we've left his mark through our grandprints on your heart. To our children's children, we've just one wish, that you'd know Jesus Christ for who he is. When all is said and done, we pray we've left his mark through our grandprints on your heart. Through our grandprints on your heart. Through our grandprints on your heart. Your pictures hang upon our wall from the time when you were small.
Amen. God, we pray for our grandkids, our children's children, as you've told us in the Word, our children's children and the children beyond them. God, that godly generations would come forth, Father God, because of our imprint, our grandprints into their lives, God. Teach us, show us, God. Show us how we can make that difference in their lives, Lord God. Those whose grandkids are far, far away, and those whose grandkids are just around the corner, God. Not replacing the parents, God, but coming alongside in godly ways. Oh, we commit these things to you for your glory. In Jesus' name, And all God's people said, amen. Amen. You know, it's just, I can't imagine the world that they're going to be facing. We think it's tough what we're going through right now, but can you imagine the future for them, these precious little children? I wrote a song many, many years ago, and I think it still applies today. It's about another little child born in a manger, the King, the majestic King of heaven and earth, Jesus Christ. Go ahead. Who would have thought that long ago, so very far away, a little child would be born and in a manger laid? And who would have thought this little child was born the King of Kings, the son of just a carpenter, yet for whom the angels sing? And who would have thought that as he grew and with other children played, this child with whom they laughed and sang would die for them someday? And who would have thought this little child could make a blind man see, feed the hungry, make rich the poor, and set the prisoner free? Oh, who would have thought this little child was who the prophet said could take away the sins of men and rise up from the dead? Many years have come and gone, yet this world remains the same. Empires have been built and fallen. Only time has made a change. Nation against nation, brother against brother, men so filled with hatred, still killing one another. And over half the world is starving, while our banner of decency is torn. Debating over disarmament, while killing children before they're born. And fools who march to win the right to justify their sin. Oh, every nation that has fallen from within. Yet in the midst of this darkness, there is a hope, a light that burns. This little child, the King of Kings, someday will return. Little child is the
King of Kings. And who would have thought this little child is who the prophet said will return to judge this world, the living and the dead. Oh, can't you see that long ago, so very far away, that Jesus Christ, our only hope, was born?
Thank you so much.